You should wear them, Catherine, for your own safety.
Yes.
You know, worry about when you think you have to wear them. You have to wear them then. Oh, yeah. Well, you see, if people are visiting and all, and they don't, you know, you don't want to get it again. What's that say? Yeah, well, me and Peter were poor. You are not saying that.
No, my
wife. You're stubborn. Anyway, I'm saying if you wanted one, I'd go and get you one. Well, there you go, Kathleen. There you go. It's nice to see you. Be coming in for coffee, are you?
Hopefully, yes.
Yeah, well, the carers can come with you if you want.
Yes, I'm going to go back. I'm going to be short
of staff. Again. Well, that's it. You see, with a pledge like that.
To go on my boat. Thank you. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Good morning.
Amen.
Welcome everybody to our celebration of Mass this morning, and a particularly warm welcome to those who came at 9:30 and have come back for 10:30. It's great that you're here, and we're all here. And as we begin, maybe I could ask the children, do you want to go to you, please? Thank you. Today's readings are very much, particularly the first reading of the Gospel, they're very much about welcome and about hospitality. And we are welcome at the table of the Lord as we gather to come to listen to his word and to be nourished from that table. So it is very much a gathering of sisters and brothers that we take part in now. And the first sign of welcome is that of forgiveness. The Lord forgives us for our sins. So let us each take a moment now to reflect on how we have been living. For those things for which we are aware of our sinfulness, let's ask God's mercy as we repent of them. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to the Father and to one another. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You have poured out on your people the Spirit of truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are the Good Shepherd, leading us to eternal life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you. Bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heaven
To your servants and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be faithful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord appeared to Abraham at the oak of Mamre while he was sitting by the entrance of the tent during the hottest part of the day. He looked up and there he saw three men standing near him. As soon as he saw them, he ran from the entrance of the tent to meet them and bowed to the ground. "My Lord," he said, "I beg you, if I find favour with you, kindly do not pass your servant by. A little water shall be brought. You shall wash your feet and lie down under the tree. Let me fetch a little bread, and you shall refresh yourselves before going further. That is why you have come in your servant's direction." They replied, "Do as you say." Abraham hastened to the tent to find Sarah. "Hurry," he said, "knead three bushels of flour and make loaves." Then, running to the cattle, Abraham took a fine and tender calf and gave it to the servant, who hurried to prepare it. Then, taking cream, milk, and the calf he had prepared, he laid all before them, and they ate while he remained standing near them under the tree. "Where is your wife, Sarah?" they asked him. "She is in the tent," he replied. Then his guest said, "I shall visit you again next year without fail, and your wife will then have a son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Accept no bribes against the innocent.
such people will stand firm forever. But just will live in the presence of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. It makes me happy to suffer for you, as I am suffering now, and in my body to do what I can to make up all that has still to be undergone by Christ for the sake of his body, the Church. I became the servant of the Church when God made me responsible for delivering God's message to you. The message, which was a mystery hidden for generations and centuries, and has now been revealed to his saints. It was God's purpose to reveal it to them and to show all the rich glory of this mystery to pagans. The mystery is Christ among you, your hope of glory. This is the Christ we proclaim. This is the wisdom in which we thoroughly train everyone and instruct everyone, to make them all perfect in Christ. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus came to a village, and a woman named Martha welcomed him into her house. She had a sister called Mary, who sat down at the Lord's feet and listened to him speaking. Now Martha, who was distracted with all the serving, said, "Lord, do you not care that my sister is leaving me to do the serving all by myself? Please, tell her to help me." But the Lord answered, "Martha, Martha," he said, "you worry and fret about so many things, and yet few are needed. Indeed, only one. It is Mary who has chosen the better part. It is not to be taken from her." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Before I came here and I was working at the Bishops' Conference, we did some work on a kind of statement about the principles that there should be for inter-religious dialogue, dialogue between people of other faiths and religions. And there was a lot of discussion about what the title of that should be, and in the end, it was known as Meeting God in Friends and Strangers. And when I read the readings for today, that title came back to my mind, because it seems to me that meeting God in friends and strangers is a good way, I hope, of just thinking a little bit more about what we've heard. And if we look at the first reading, Abraham does nothing more than anyone would have done in his culture at the time. Nomadic peoples relied on the hospitality of each other and being given welcome. Sometimes that could literally be a matter of life and death. And perhaps what is also important here is the way in which Abraham greets his guests. There are three of them, and we're told that he bows low and greets them in the singular. "My Lord," he says. And we can understand that as being a visit from God, accompanied by angels. And subsequently, that is something that has been depicted many times in art and in icons. And there is that request that he makes of his visitors, not to pass him by. And hopefully for us, that has echoes of Jesus walking on the road to Emmaus after his resurrection, being encountered as a stranger. He makes as though to go on, and though he's pressed to stay. And so the apostles recognize him at the breaking of bread. And when they go back, they say, "We have seen the Lord." The Lord, God, is to be found in welcoming the stranger. In the gospel, on the other hand, there could be what has become an excuse for all lazy people when they're challenged about not doing their fair share. I can hear myself as a teenager saying at home, "But I've chosen the better part. I went to church this morning." But of course, that's not what it was about. Jesus is in the house of Martha and Mary and Lazarus. What we've heard this morning comes from the Gospel of Luke, and he comes to know them very well. In the other Gospels, by this point, he has already known them very well. He has visited them, and they are his friends. He was at home and with a family that he knew. And he's just told the parable of the Good Samaritan, which is about the help given to a stranger by a stranger. But here he is being welcomed into a family home. And in a way, that juxtaposing of his teaching and his actions are about getting our priorities right and not forgetting that we find God in friends and the family and the familiar as well. And so taken together, the readings speak to us of welcome. Not only that genuine and warm welcome for the stranger, but also the welcome that we should and must give to each other, to the family, to the familiar, to friends and acquaintances who we see day in, day out. It's really important that we are greeting each other and our welcoming to each other with equal enthusiasm and attention, even when we know each other so well. And that can be difficult, because sometimes in the familiar there is also the memory of tension and anger. But that's what we must do. We must find God equally in friend and stranger, even if often, a bit like Martha, we think we know better. So let's stand now and together proclaim our faith as we say the Creed. And we'll use the second version of the Creed, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Gathered and welcomed at the table of the Lord, let us now pray to the Father with our bidding prayer.
For the Church in Ukraine, that the Pope and the bishops of Ukraine will seek peace and an end to the suffering of the war, spreading God's message of love and peace above all else. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For health service leaders, may they continue to provide care and treatment, delivering a plan for all our health needs as we continue in a world affected by COVID. For victims of trafficking, for those that have suffered, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For victims of trafficking, for those that have suffered as refugees, slaves, and through being trafficked, may they hear the word of God and through it gain hope and peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For the churches of Skipton and the Dales, may the churches of Skipton and the Dales continue to support all in the community that need help. Like Martha and Mary, may they spread the word of the Lord by their example and service to all who need food, both physical and spiritual. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Let us pause for a moment to pray silently, remembering also in our prayers Bill and Mary Collins, for whom this Mass is offered. We ask Mary, our Mother in Heaven, to join her prayers with ours as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Father, we ask you to hear these and all our prayers, and may we show your Son's welcome to all whom we meet, so that we may grow as his living body, for he is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Welcome back. You're going to say good morning?
Morning.
Good. Now, I understand you're going to do a play. Must be having an extra hour in bed that gives you all this energy. So I'm going to hand you over to Carmel.
Father. Okay, everybody. We've got lots of budding actors this morning. So we're going to do a play. And yes, hopefully you will appreciate it. Okay, Anna?
Okay. So first of all, we need the props for Bella and the Bella. Well done. So going through.
Hello, who's this? You're kidding me. You're Jesus. And you'd like to come to dinner? Whoa, I really need to clean my house. It's a mess.
Ding dong, ding dong.
Can you please help me? My car just broke down.
Sorry, Jesus is coming to dinner and I'm too busy to help you.
Hi, I live next door and I was wondering if we could have a chat about something, please.
Really sorry, but Jesus is coming to dinner. Can't you see I'm busy?
Okay. Can you knock on the door?
Hello, we're collecting money to help people who are poor around the world. Can you help us, please?
Can you come back tomorrow? I'm too busy today.
Ring, 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 ring.
Hello. Oh, hello, Jesus. Where are you? I've cooked and cleaned for hours, and you haven't shown up or told me when you're coming. What do you mean? You came to me 3 times, and I've turned you away. Did I? When? What a day. I'm starving.
The end. Thank you.
Well done. Thank you. So that just shows that we need to always welcome everyone, because Jesus comes with them. So, is that everything? A prayer. Excellent. Who's doing the prayer?
Lord Jesus, we pray that we will always make you welcome and be ready to spend time listening to the word of the God. Amen.
Amen. Thank you all very much indeed. Well done. Thank you. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion the varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants, and make it holy, as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honour of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For the Eucharistic prayer this morning, I'm going to use the fourth part of the fifth Eucharistic prayer, which is Jesus who went about doing good, and it begins on page 52 in the books. The Lord be with you.
Yes,
lift up your hearts.
Yes,
let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Yes,
it is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God, for you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners, and he became a neighbour to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father, and that you care for all your sons and daughters. And so, with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name and sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. And to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this all of you and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Saviour, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. And we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favour on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis our Pope and Marcus our Bishop, with all bishops, priests and deacons, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters, inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labour and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ. Remember Mary and Bill Collins, for whom this Mass is offered, and all the dead, whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with St. Stephen, St. Margaret Clitheroe, with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours for ever and ever.
Amen.
Let's pray now for the coming of God's kingdom as Jesus has taught us to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your